surprised when you told them that you had applied to be part of the Mars One project?
Well, to be honest with you, I do have a lot of family. Obviously, with being transgender, when I transitioned, I lost my family, which again, I think is sort of another advantage I've got because I'm not really leaving anybody behind. And I think that's going to be one of the things, the hardest things for anybody to do is go leaving family. And I don't have that problem. So family aren't really in this. Friends, yeah, there was a little bit shocked, and it was, you know, is this real? And I said, well, sit back, watch, you'll see whether it's real or not.
Now, certainly, if you're selected to go, you're going to be on a team of four, so those three other people are essentially going to become your new family. That's for the next few years as you're out there waiting for the next team to arrive. You're going to be just the four of you out there alone. So are you excited about the possibility of just being part of a new family, starting a new civilization? Do you feel that pressure at all?
I think it's a fantastic start to life, because that's what we're going to be doing, is starting a new life. And what better way to do it than people who you've been close to with training for so long, you know each other. Yeah, we'll all be family and we'll be going up there and starting life. Yeah, I'm so excited about that.
So now, we've talked about this briefly, Dr. Kraft, in terms of, it's pretty much as you said, up to these four people, once they go out there, how they want to kind of govern themselves. But during the 10 years of training, are you just exposing them to different forms of governing, or is this something that you're just not even really touching on and just letting them sort of discover themselves?
Yes, you're right. So I let them discover by themselves. So because I said we want to have mature people, so we don't just tell them you try this out, we will teach them, we give them suggestions, what would be ideal. However, I want that they decide by themselves and try it out. Because I think the best thing is experiential learning, learning through experience. So let's say the groups decide suddenly we want to make an anarchy, and then they say, oh my God, we are the worst in the pool. Every other group is much better than us. Then they figure out, okay, this was not the way to go. Maybe we should change it. And only when they really experience, they remember it and they will keep it up. Instead, if you teach them a flowchart and say, yes, yes, this is right, and then it's not working out.
So is the idea every time they go to that 3 months of isolation during the training that they would maybe try a different form of how they want to govern themselves?
No, that's up to them, totally. Okay. They can flip every week, every day,
whatever
they want for every challenge. So they really can try it out by themselves, and we will see, and we will watch, we'll see what really works. And maybe for some groups, something works better than for the others. We don't know. Not each group is the same. Interesting, it will be, when you mentioned before, when the two meet. And one find out, okay, our structure is this way, your structure is that way. What happen if our structures coming together? But we will practice and train these things too to see how they work it out.
So at some point during, would it be potentially, you have two teams in isolation for 3 months each, and then right at the end you bring them together and just see how they interact?
For example, yeah.
Okay. So it's not just necessarily for the training, it's not necessarily going to be just like medical or science or technology, but also history, interpersonal dynamics as well, psychology is part of the training as
yes,
well?
Yes, we have definitely psychology training, group training, and it will be always with the experience, with the challenges we do, we have after feedback and then we have probing questions and then they do a new experiment, see did they learn out of it, what did they take out. Yes, this training is one of the big ones actually involved.
So, Melissa, when you hear about what Dr. Kraft has sort of in mind for what the experience would be like during the training, are you excited about this when you hear about Dr. Kraft explaining it a little bit?
I'm really excited about it. Yeah, I mean, what I'm about to do is things I've never ever done before, and I love learning, and I love trying new things, and yeah, it really does excite me. It doesn't frighten me whatsoever. Some people may be put off by the fact that they're going to go into things that they've never done before, but that gives me excitement. That's what I thrive on.